last year out here, we conducted a proof of concept experiment where we showed that it's technically feasible to pump seawater and atomise it into trillions per second of tiny little seawater droplets, which in theory can go on to help brighten clouds and cool the reef. This year, what we're really interested in looking at is the behaviour of that plume of sea salt droplets as it drifts away from the boat. There's a few critical questions around that. How many of those droplets make it up to cloud height? And how does the atmospheric turbulence and the winds spread those droplets? And these questions will help us to design a system for the future that may be able to work over the whole reef. This fieldwork mission has several components. One of the components is to collect background atmospheric data. So we have a whole lab set up on the ship that's sampling air from up at the front of the boat, the wind, before it hits the boat. And we're looking at all of the background properties of particles that are naturally floating around in the air out here on the reef. Another part further back on the ship is the cloud brightening prototype, and it's Mark II this year, so it's producing around twice as many droplets as last year. And we're very interested in how those droplets are spreading through the atmosphere. So we have a big focus this year on using drones as sampling platforms to measure the plume, not just in a horizontal dimension, but also in a vertical dimension. So one of the great advances that we've made from last year is really our sampling platforms. So the boat that we're using for sampling downwind is now larger and much more capable, and we're actually able to launch drones and retrieve drones off of that boat.
As well as being important to the Indigenous people of Australia, we realise it's important to all Australians. We love the coast, we love our water. Let's look after it together.
Cloud brightening is just one of a whole suite of ideas that we're examining in the Reef Restoration and Adaptation Program. And the overarching goal of all of this research is to look into all of the possible ways we can think of that we might be able to help the reef to survive climate change.